أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أفضل الأنبياء وسيد المرسلين سيدنا رسول الله وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين ورضي الله عن أصحابه وأزواجه وذريته وأحبابه وأتباعه أجمعين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته and welcome back my dear brothers and sisters once again to Once Upon a Dua. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us as we come closer to these final 10 days in Ramadan. And today we are discussing the dua related to the night of Qadr or the night of power or honor. And we'll get into that. Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah brings us only one single hadith in this chapter. And that is with an authentic chain as he states to Imam al-Tirmidhi and Nasa'i wa Ibn Majah, three of the famous hadith scholars that wrote three out of the famous six books. And they all narrate from Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha Ummul Mu'mineen, our dearest mother. And it is worth mentioning that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the commemoration of the passing of Sayyida Aisha, which just has left us, that we all get the opportunity to be with our mother Ummul Mu'mineen in Jannah, and we all get the opportunity to inherit some of the characteristics of our great mother Sayyida Aisha Ummul Mu'mineen wa alayha salam. And we all get to be with our mother on the day of Qiyamah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with her, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise her in rank as much as she deserves and as much as possible. And so with that, Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha wa alayha salam narrates to us, and she said, I asked al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam that if I know it is the night of Qadr or the night of Qadr, then what should I say? And he answered that, say, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. And the night of Qadr, or Qadr, as the scholars say, has two different ways of pronouncing it. The first, so we have understanding, is Qadr with a sukoon on the dal. That means you join qaf and dal and dhara, Qadr. And this means to honor someone or to honor a night. And the night of honor is because the night, it is the night that the Quran was revealed. And so therefore the scholars have that understanding. Because the Quran was revealed, it was an honor for this night because the Quran came down. And also the scholars have the understanding that Qadr, which means you put a fatha on the dal. So that Qadr is power. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also tells us, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim in Surah Al-Qadr, that salamun hiya hatta matla'i al-fajr, that it is a night of power, Qadr, but there is salam in that Qadr. For power can oftentimes be destructive. It can destroy you from inwards and from outwards. But if there is salam, if there is peace and tranquility with that power, then it is a good power. It is a night that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us is a night of power. Why? Because Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alfi shahr. That this Laylatul Qadr, the night of power, is better than 1,000 months. So therefore, that worship in the night of Laylatul Qadr is very powerful. But there is peace and tranquility in it. So that's the understanding, very basic understanding of Laylatul Qadr or Laylatul Qadr. So you can pronounce it either way, and they both give different meanings and different understandings for this beautiful night. And with that, when we say the night of honor as well, it is a night that is honoring us if we get to discover it and we get to understand it and we get to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in it. So therefore it is an honor for us. And so moving on to our dua for the day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the tongue of al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is telling us to ask for afwa. And afwa, on the very basic meaning and very basic translation, it means forgiveness. But afwa is so much more than that. And why is it that al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is telling us to seek afwa instead of maghfira or ghafara. So maghfira means forgiveness as well. And when we seek istighfar, we are seeking forgiveness. But afwa is different. You see, afwa in the translation and in the understanding, when we say something is afwa or intifa', it means to obliterate as well. So when you ask for istighfar or maghfira, you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. But in that forgiveness, that sin that you may have had or that deed that you are asking for forgiveness for may still be written down in the books. That is the understanding. But when you ask for afwa, then that sin that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving you for can be obliterated completely, meaning it was like it was never there. And that's why it is so important to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for afwa on the night of Qadr or the night of Qadr. And also, not just that, afwa has a meaning of asking or thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rather, or giving thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As you know, in the Arab world, when generally you would say shukran, which means thank you, people would say afwan, you are welcome, or thank you as well, as it is translated in the dictionaries. So that underlying meaning of thanks also is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we should keep that in mind when we ask for afwa. It is forgiveness, it is thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is in hopes that our sin will be completely obliterated. And then another meaning of afwa is humility and humbling yourself before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how is that? Generally, you would find in the Arab world, again, when you would perhaps walk past someone and perhaps you may nudge them by mistake or knock them, then you would say afwan, excuse me. Or even when you want to gather someone's attention and maybe possibly to ask the time, then you would say afwan to gather their attention, like excuse me, can I please have your attention? So you are humbling yourself. And therefore, afwa is also humbling yourself before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is a higher level of seeking forgiveness. And on this beautiful night of Laylatul Qadr, we should be constantly asking, Allahumma innaka afuwan tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. But we should remember these underlying meanings of afwa when we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is forgiveness, that is thankfulness, that is obliteration of the sin which you may have caused, or the action which you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive, and it is humbling yourself before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So have that intention in your heart when you make this dua. And Imam al-Shafi'i, as Imam al-Nawawi narrates to us, is said that, or he tells us rather, that it is mustahab, or it is recommended that we supplicate this as much as possible in abundance on the night of Qadr or the night of Qadr. And also he recommends that we read as much Quran as possible and all the authentic mustahab actions, or all the authentic recommended actions. We should be doing this throughout the night and exert ourselves to the utmost capability in this night. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, Laylatul Qadri khayrun min alfi shahr, that it is better than 1,000 months, and that is more than the average lifetime. So therefore, we should take heed of this opportunity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us, and keep on asking for afwa so that you can go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that day where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge us, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will either take us into the fire or the paradise. And we all want to go to the paradise, so we want to have a clean slate when we go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, take heed of this opportunity, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be a sitir to us on that day. May He cover us and our sins on that day, so that it is only between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and no one else. And with that, my dear brothers and sisters, we come to a close of this session and this episode of Once Upon a Dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to recognize the night of قادر أو قادر. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.